friends, I'm Dr. Neha Taneja. So today we're going to discuss about a very, very important topic that comes as your university questions also, and definitely MCQs is topic se aate hi hai. It is none other than Hill's criteria of causal association. Now, kya hai ye topic? Let us try to understand that. Theek hai? All the study designs that I have taught you so far, whether it's case control, cohort, cross-sectional, RCT, hum kya kar rahe hain? Hum sab mein ek relationship dikha rahe hain between two variables, right? And what are those two variables? They are exposure and outcome. Theek hai? We are trying to establish a relationship between these two variables. The relationship between these two variables is depicted by two terms. ठीक है? वो दो terms क्या है? Association, okay? And the second one is causal association. ठीक है? Now, association मतलब क्या होता है? It simply means that two variables occur together more often than we would expect by chance. ठीक है? Two variables occur together, ठीक है? More often, okay? More often than expected by chance. मतलब, whenever we talk about lung cancer, you will see smoking is always being talked about along with lung cancer. जब भी lung cancer की बात हो रही है, smoking की बात हो रही है. कोई cross-sectional study कर रहा है तब और lung cancer, तभी भी smoking is coming as a risk factor. Somebody is doing some other study design also, then also smoking is always associated with lung cancer. So that is association. Now the second part, ki whether this association is causal or not, which means, okay, whether association causal or not, okay, is causal or not, is what is given by Hill's criteria. Matlab, whether smoking is a cause of lung cancer is established by Hill's criteria. Okay, this is what we will try to study today. एक एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चन है हिल्स क्राइटेरिया का दूसरा नाम क्या है इट इज सर्जन्स जनरल क्राइटेरिया आल्सो इट्स कॉल्ड दिस आल्सो सो इफ यू गेट दिस वर्ड डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज्ड ठीक है तो अब वी विल बी लुकिंग एट ऑल दोस क्राइटेरियाज व्हिच विल एस्टैब्लिश कॉसालिटी नाउ लेट अस ट्राई टू हैव अ लुक एट दीस क्राइटेरियाज देयर आर 8 important criteria which you need to know because MCQ banta hai seedha most important criteria, most difficult criteria. Okay, so what are those 8 important criteria? The first one is temporality. Temporality is the most important. Okay, we'll see how. Next one is specificity. The most difficult criteria to establish or the least important. Okay? Next, I'm just telling you a way how you should remember it. Ab dekho, pehle we spoke about the most important and the most difficult. After that, we'll go alphabetical wise. Next comes biological plausibility. Then comes consistency. Then comes coherence. Then comes cessation of exposure. Then comes DSA, dose response relationship, and last may strength of association. So, kaise yaad rakhoge? The first is ki in criteria mein which is the most important. So you remember that. Okay, temporality. Which is the most difficult? Specificity. Then you go in order. B se biological plausibility, 3 C se hai consistency, coherence, cessation of exposure, dose response, and strength of association. Now we look at each of the criteria one by one. Now the first criteria and the most important is temporality. If you remember, we had studied this temporality in one of the study designs. Yes, if you remember, it was cohort study. Okay? So temporality matlab kya hota hai? It simply means that the cause, okay, should precede अगर लंग कैंसर किसी को हो रहा है तो उसके पहले दैट ही और शी मस्ट हैव हैड स्मोकिंग एज अ रिस्क फैक्टर. दैट मीन्स स्मोकिंग शुड लीड टू लंग कैंसर. ठीक है, ड्रिंकिंग एल्कोहल शुड लीड टू से पैंक्रियाटिक कैंसर और समथिंग. ओके, सो द कॉज शुड प्रीसीड इफेक्ट. And if you remember, this was best established by which study design? None other than cohort study design. Okay? So this is the most important criteria which needs to be established. Next criteria that we talk about is specificity. Now, why? Because this is the most difficult criteria to be established. Why is it the most difficult? Specificity matlab kya hota hai? कि एक पर्टिकुलर रिस्क फैक्टर शुड बी एसोसिएटेड विद जस्ट वन डिजीज. ठीक है, विच इज ऑफ कोर्स नॉट अ पॉसिबिलिटी. जैसे स्मोकिंग शुड ओनली लीड टू लंग कैंसर, दैट इज नॉट द केस. स्मोकिंग इज अ रिस्क फैक्टर फॉर मेनी अदर कैंसर्स. ओरल कैंसर हो गया, एनी अदर कैंसर, पैंक्रियाटिक कैंसर हो गया, एनीथिंग. ठीक है, देन वी कैन हैव. सो स्मोकिंग इज बेसिकली इट्स नॉट जस्ट एसोसिएटेड विथ वन डिजीज, इट इज अ रिस्क फैक्टर फॉर सो मेनी डिजीजेस. दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ स्पेसिफिसिटी. देयरफॉर इट बिकम्स द मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट एंड लीस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट क्राइटेरियन टू एस्टैब्लिश. नेक्स्ट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट बायोलॉजिकल. दिस इज द थर्ड वन. फर्स्ट वॉज टेम्पोरालिटी, देन वॉज स्पेसिफिसिटी. ठीक है, देन वी टॉक्ड अबाउट बायोलॉजिकल प्लॉसिबिलिटी. Plausibility. What does this means? That whatever you are saying, okay, should be supported by a biological background. It should have a sound biological knowledge. Okay, it should be supported by some biological fact. It should be coherent with some biological fact. अगर हम कह रहे हैं तो smoking, मेरे study design में comes out that smoking is a cause of lung cancer. Then we all know that what does smoking do? Smoking affects our lung. Lung parenchyma ko affect karta hai, isn't it? And this irritation, it irritates the lung parenchyma, it damages the lung parenchyma, and this starts carcinogenesis. So if mere study design mein it comes out that smoking is a risk factor for lung cancer, it is supported by a biological explanation, which is this. Theek hai? So this is the third one. Fourth kya hai? All the C's. Consistency. Matlab results should be replicable. Okay, it means results should be replicable in different settings. Okay guys, what does this mean? That results should be replicable in different settings. It should be, you know, it should be supported by us. It should basically be, if I do a particular study to establish a fact, jaise maine smoking is a cause of risk factor for lung cancer, ya cause of lung cancer, I established that fact in Delhi by a study design, okay, by a cohort study. It should also be, if a person does it in, say, West Bengal, in, say, Chennai, in, say, some other part of the country or some other part of the world, in Pakistan, Afghanistan, America, it should, again, the same finding should come out. Okay? So that is consistency, that results should be replicated in different settings. Agar hum aaj keh rahe that alcohol leads to CVD in rural areas, then alcohol should lead to CVD in urban areas as well. Okay? This coherence of association. Okay? What does this mean? That studies should support each other's results. ठीक है, each other results. That means क्या हुआ, अगर मैंने एक study किया and it comes out that smoking is a risk factor for lung cancer. Somebody else does it that smoking is a risk factor for lung cancer in females. Now somebody else does the same study that smoking is a risk factor for lung cancer in males. So all these studies, three different people did, but what was one common factor? That smoking, lung cancer, occurs together. Okay? So that is what is meant by coherence of association. Okay? Next two are very simple if we try to understand that. Let me just tell you. Next was cessation of exposure. Okay? Cessation of exposure, kya hota hai? Simple. if you decrease or reduce the exposure, okay, if exposure decreased, what will happen? There will be reduced chance of the outcome or the disease. Okay, that means if a person stops smoking, reduces smoking, the chance of occurrence of lung cancer reduces. Right? Very simple. Next is what? Dose response relationship. What is this? Just compare it with the first one, cessation of exposure. Dose response matlab, agar hum dose badhate hain, the response increases. What does that mean? If somebody smokes one cigarette in a week, in a day, the chances of lung cancer is, you know, so much. If the person starts smoking 5 cigarettes in a day, the chances of lung cancer is increased 2 times. If a person starts smoking 10 cigarettes a day, it's even further increased. So that is the meaning of dose response relationship. Ye yaad rakhne ke liye, you can study it contrasting way. Exposure ko band karo, kam karo, outcome reduces. Dose response, dose badhao, outcome ka chance or disease ka chance badh jata hai. Theek hai? Then, the last one that we studied or we talked about was strength of association. Now, guys, just take a minute and remember, we have spoken about strength of association so many times. Theek hai? Strength of association matlab exposure and outcome. That exposure is likely associated with outcome. That strength is depicted by two very important parameters. It was odds ratio in a case of case control study. Okay? And it was relative risk in cohort study design. Okay? Just try and remember, cohort or case control mein strength of association is better given by, of course, cohort study. Why? Because it also tells you the incidence of a disease. How it is best establishing temporality. Agar we have two groups, we divide them into exposed and non-exposed and we follow them over a period of time to see how many develop the disease and how many do not develop. So, aapko kya mila? You also find out the incidence of the disease. So, that is the last criteria, which is strength of association. Isko simple terms mein agar koi puche with an example, to aap kya bologe? That smoking will occur 80 to 90% ya smoking will be a risk factor rather. Okay, in 80 to 90% of patients with lung cancer. Okay, jitne bhi mere paas patients honge lung cancer ke, we will see that smoking is always present as a risk factor in 80 to 90% of those lung cancer cases. Okay, so this was about Hill's criteria, 10 mark uni question aata hai, most important criteria MCQ ke liye. Temporality, most difficult to establish, specificity. Okay, don't forget this. This is very important. So if you have any comments, drop in the comment section below and I hope you've liked this video. Thank you so much for watching.